Hey, we have some special guests tonight. Have you noticed the ladies in red right here? And we got one pink lady. No, this is the adult and teen challenge that is not far out of Lafayette. It's kind of between Cecilia, Arnaville, Brobridge. Is that where it's located-ish? Sherrington. I'm from Franklin. Meh. I thought y'all were on the northern side. No, this is my home people. We're probably related. No, we just want to welcome them and to give you a quick snapshot. It is a faith-based recovery program to take some people who are going through some struggles. How many of you know what I'm talking about? Amen. And they take them through a program. They give them help. They give them resources. They teach them. They train them. They pray for them. And lo and behold, they come out of that program different, delivered, set free, and ready to do the work of the Lord. And ladies, I just want to share this with you. I have a scripture. I want to put it up. I believe the Lord gave me this late this afternoon for you. It's Romans 15:13. It says this: May the God of hope fill you, Teen Challenge, with all joy and peace as you trust in Him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. So not only do you have hope and see the hope and experience the hope, but it says here that you're going to have hope and overflow to go help somebody else. Amen. It's about paying it forward. So I believe that's a word from the Lord for you. So anyway, they've got a special program for us tonight, and I want to welcome Afton to come up and just tell you a little bit about it. And so would you do a warm FLC welcome to Adult and Teen Challenge?
Yes, my name is Afton, and I've been with the ministry now for 8 years, and I'm the teacher at our center, and we also have our program director, Ms. Colleen, who's been with the ministry for 10 years. 8 years ago, if you'd have told me I'd be standing here today, I'd have told you you've lost your mind, because my plan was to end my life, but God, He had another plan, and now I'm an ordained minister and in Bible college, and God has... Only God did that. And He used the ministry of Teen Challenge to save and set me free from the bondage of addiction. And I have the opportunity each and every day to minister to these ladies. And we're an induction center, so these ladies will be with us for 4 months, and then they'll transition to Winfield. And the amazing thing about our center is we get to see them come off the streets. We get to see them when they have no hope. They think they have no hope. We get to see the rugged, the part that nobody else probably wants to see and wants to deal with. We get to do that. And we get to see them grow, and we get to see them change. And that's just an amazing opportunity. And, Teen Challenge is an 18-month program. We have two parts. You have the classroom, which is my favorite part, and you also have the work detail. And in the classroom, they're learning scriptures, they're learning character qualities, they're learning a foundation to stand on. Because without the foundation, they can go through this whole program and go back to what they left. Because you have to have a foundation in Christ. And so we teach them that in the classroom. And the work detail is where they're fleshing out what they're learning in the classroom, because they have to be able to work it out. And so that's what we get to do. We now have 9 centers across the state. We have a family center in Minden, and then we have 5 men's centers and 3 women's centers. And we have a unique center in West Monroe now, that we're offering a 30 to 90 day program, because not everybody can and is willing to stop everything for 18 months. They're not, you know, and we just want to have help for everybody. And so this is an opportunity for us to reach those that can't take 18 months off of their life, you know. And we only offer a $750 induction fee, which really only covers the cost of the education expenses. We're nonprofit because we talk about Jesus. But it's because we talk about Jesus that sets people free. But it's the Jesus factor that the government won't help us. So we started 65 years ago by a man named David Wilkerson. He started the ministry on prayer. He gave up his TV and started the ministry on prayer. He prayed instead of watching TV for 2 hours at night. And we started with one center in New York, and now we have 200 across the U.S. and 1,400 across the country. And that is so many lives being touched, so many people being transformed. Because addiction is real. We sometimes don't want to talk about it in church, but it's real. Addiction is real. In 2022, over 100,000 people died from addiction. That is 100,000 families touched, even more. You know, and so we come out here to do ministry so that we can get the word out, so that we can share what our ministry's doing, so that we can offer help to those that need it, so that they see there is help and there is hope. And so today you will hear testimonies of these ladies and what God has done in their lives. And you will see what we're doing in the classroom too, because we're doing goodbye letters, spoken words. And this is just things that we are doing in the classroom. And so we will start with a testimony video.
Hello, I'm Greg Dill. This is my wife, Gail. We've had the privilege of serving Louisiana Adult and Teen Challenge for over 40 years now. We started with one facility in New Orleans and have since grown to 8 across our state. We have 5 for men, 3 for women. In one of the women's facilities, the ladies are able to come in either pregnant and or with children. We're very blessed to be able to offer that.
We have been able to experience serving in this ministry for over 40 years, and I'm excited to be able to share with you what we get to experience on a daily basis.
I was in addiction for 15 years. I lost my kids in foster care. I went through a divorce. I was destroyed by drugs and the bad decisions in my life.
After about 20 years of addiction, in and out of prison, my daughter looked me in my face with tears running down her eyes. Said, I don't want you to die, Mom. I don't want you to die. And I still had to shoot up. I couldn't stop.
I lost my son in a tragic house fire. And that was at that moment that I knew that I needed to change and I needed something bigger than me to help me.
I struggled with a meth addiction that just destroyed my life in such a short amount of time.
I was addicted to prescription pills and spent about 15 years just fighting for my life in this addiction that almost took me out.
It was like a horror movie, and I saw the people that I was hurting, my children that I was neglecting. I was strung out on crystal meth, crack cocaine.
And I had a little girl at the end of my addiction, and I wound up going to prison when she was 3.
Spent many years in addiction, grew up in a broken home, spent a lot of time in and out of jails, different programs, and Christ finally got a hold of me, and I made my way to Teen Challenge.
God used Teen Challenge to help facilitate what he had already done in my life. Because he's the author of our change. Teen Challenge can't change a life, but Teen Challenge can be there to help facilitate God's grace, and that's what they did.
God brought me to a point in my life where I had to surrender everything, and in that, I found my way to Louisiana Adult and Teen Challenge.
Went through the program, God started to transform my life, and it was there that I met my lovely wife, Hannah. I've been here ever since. Now I serve as the program director for the Lafayette Men's Campus.
This place had people with substance, and if they said it, they did it. And I remember thinking, this is the first thing in my life I've found that has substance, and now I know it's because they stood on the truth of the gospel.
God has been restoring my family to me little by little, and I just know it's by his grace and his mercy that I'm still here, and I just feel like a completely different person. God's transformed me physically, mentally, and spiritually.
I just graduated LSU with my bachelor's in social work. I just feel like God has called me to help kids that were like me.
God slowly but surely started putting my life back together. I have full custody of my kids. I've been sober now for plus 2 years. I have a full-time job. I have a home. I have a vehicle, a driver's license, a GED. I have everything that I never had before, and it wasn't until I came to Louisiana Adult and Teen Challenge and God changed my life.
Past graduation and my daughter moved back in with me. It was her decision and my family's decision. They were just so blown away by what God had done in my life that they knew it was time for her to come home.
I'm participating in the Next Steps at Our Savior's Church in Opelousas. God's just doing miraculous things in my life and I just couldn't be more grateful.
One word to describe my life since Louisiana Teen Challenge is restored.
An unbelievable, fulfilling,
whole and complete.
Now we have our cardboard testimonies. My Jesus.
Are you past the point of weary? Is your burden weighing heavy? Is it all too much to carry? Let me tell you about my Jesus. Do you feel that empty feeling? 'Cause shame's done all it's stealing. And you're desperate for some healing. Let me tell you about my Jesus. He makes a way where there ain't no way. Rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sinner that he can save. Let me tell you about my Jesus. His love is strong and his grace is free. And the good news is I know that he can do for you what he's done for me. Let me tell you about my Jesus. And let my Jesus change your life.
So now we're going to do Truth Is Reality as Mandy, Tara, and Caitlin. All right.
What is reality? Reality is every man, including your father, has made you feel like you are and will never be enough. Reality is turning to fentanyl roxies to cope with your kids due to anxiety. Reality is those fentanyl roxies turned into heroin because you are ashamed that you chose the street life and your organization over your kids. How do I know that's reality? Because that was me.
What is reality? Reality is starting drugs and alcohol at 15 years old to cope with bullying in school and issues at home. Reality is, at 29 years old, getting hit by an 18-wheeler on the interstate, leading to a pain pill addiction for over 11 years. What is reality? Reality is running to a man in recovery and relapsing with him and falling into an IV addiction of heroin and Xanax. It killed him and it almost took her out too. How do I know that's reality? Because that was me.
What is reality? Reality is being told you'll become a junkie like your parent once was. Reality is staying at your friend's house, getting abused, thinking it was okay to stay silent. Reality is believing it was normal for your family to fist fight and argue. How do I know that was reality? Because that was me.
Although we may have different realities, we've all been saved and set free from the same truth. 2 Corinthians 5:17 states, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come and the old has gone." The truth is, my God is showing me that I am not alone and he will never abandon me. The truth is that anxiety is nothing but of the flesh, and God has allowed trials and tribulations to occur in my life so that he could come in and save me. The truth is, my God is a forgiving God. My God has forgiven me for what I put my children through and has set me free from that shame. He has shown me that I can throw that street life behind me and be the mother that God intended me to be.
Truth is, I've forgiven those people who've hurt me because my God forgave me. Truth is, I no longer allow pain to control my life because God heals all things. Truth is, I now have a purpose to look forward to in my life because Jesus gave me a second chance.
Truth is, I am not my parent, and we both have been set free. Truth is, I am safe and comforted by God's unconditional love. Truth is, I no longer have to defend myself because my Heavenly Father fights for me.
And Jesus said, "You shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free."
All right, so now we have a testimony. Miss Lisa, how long you been with us?
2 months.
She's been with us for 2 months.
Hi, my name's Lisa. I'm from Shreveport, Louisiana, and I'm 53 years old. I have two brothers, Eric and Kevin, an 8-year-old poodle named Louie.
I had two great parents. I couldn't ask for better parents. At 14, I started following the wrong set of friends, and that's where my addictions began. It started marijuana, then Xanax. By the time I was 26, I was taking 10 quad bars of Xanax a day and forgetting weeks at a time. And if that didn't kill me, came powder cocaine and ecstasy. At 29, I started doing meth. That's when I found out I couldn't have kids. Devastated, that was my excuse to do all I wanted. I was working at the casino, seemed like 24 hours a day, making good money. I thought I needed the meth. No one noticed my addiction in there. They were too focused on their own. I thought it'd take a lot longer to get to 53, but here we are. One night on a meth bench, I had a massive stroke. And that's where God set me down and said, "Lisa, now what?" full of shame, disappointed in myself. And with the help of my dad, I found myself at Teen Challenge looking for that sweet girl I once was. Well, I'm finding her there with the help of staff and the sisters I never had. And words can't convey how much my heart thanks them. And Jesus, thank you for never leaving my side when I thought I was alone. Sincerely, Lisa.
Okay, now, chain breaker. Jennifer, and she's going to give a spoken word, which is a testimony in a poetry form. Jennifer, you've been with us for 3 months?
I'm going into my fourth.
She's going into her fourth month. Wow.
Hello, my name is Jennifer Lynn, and I am from the Mississippi Gulf Coast, Biloxi, partially raised there, and then my adult life, I was raised in Louisiana, right here, New Iberia, Lafayette. And this is my spoken word. It quiets my guilt, yet strengthens my anger. In return, it creates a facade or a fantasy of a tough girl, a woman, chick, lady. In my world, an organization The nation, it means everything. Respect, loyalty, strength, almighty nation. And so this is where the meth and the madness begins. A sniffle here, a weep there. A drink here, a hit there. Now up, up, and away we go with a rail of deception straight to my nose. Slowly I bow my head to cry a tear. Oh, come on, Jan, hurry up. Just let's get dressed. Let's get to the casino and go have a few beers. There goes day one, quickly turning into day two. All cheered up. Now I'm slot machine ready. As I press those buttons without a care, here it comes. The rush of pain, the cloud of guilt, and the heavy weight of despair. Oh, go on, hurry up. Let's get home. Your friend in the dark is waiting for you there. My drug of all drugs. The one that helps pick me up from out that mud. Yet it fills my head with broken dreams, funky schemes, and alibis that are full of nothing but the devil's lies. It speaks to me loudly. It tells me, yo, chick, you have plenty to spare. Go on, get up, get out there, go share. And thank the Lord I did, and for getting in my face and bringing me here to this humble little place. Where these almighty women are teaching me the ropes of peace, love, freedom, and grace. While teaching me to stomp the devil up and forever out of my space. Respect was neglect. Loyalty was abandonment. Strong was abused. No thank you, devil. I no longer feel used. Respect to my Lord, loyalty to my Prince, strength to my spirit. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9 says, but you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for his own possessions, that you may proclaim his excellency, the excellencies of him who called you out of the darkness and into his marvelous light. Former follower of a sin-filled organization, now training to be a warrior for Jesus, to speak one truth. I am now one nation, and that nation now, y'all, is a holy nation. And that nation's under God. So I, Jennifer Lynn, I lay down my rag and I pick up my cross. Cause Mr. Jesus Christ is my heavenly new high boss.
So we have Brittany, and she's going to do her goodbye letter. You've been with us for
3 months.
All right.
Hi, my name is Brittany. I'm 40 years old, and I'm from Louisiana. I'm from Ville Platte. This is not just my goodbye letter, but this is also a demonstration of what God is doing over at Teen Challenge, because while y'all don't know this, these ladies and my leaders know that I have a horrible fear of speaking in public. So here is my goodbye letter to my lack of self-confidence. I have lived with you for so long that I don't even recognize myself in the mirror anymore. I have not always felt this way. There was a time when I was a vibrant, beautiful, and confident girl. I've asked myself, what happened? And lack of self-confidence, how did you become so ingrained in my life? Well, it turns out that when you are living at the bottom of a bottle, there is no room for strength, happiness, or confidence in there. But I have some exciting news, lack of self-confidence. Maybe not for you, but definitely for me. Now that God has built me a new house away from that bottle, I no longer live in that same cramped space. So it's time for you to pack your bags and go. God has made room in my life for all the positive characteristics that he has gifted me with to return back to me. So this is your official eviction letter from me, signed by the power of God.
That is the conclusion of our program, and I just thank y'all for having us tonight.
Would y'all stand and give them a warm applause? Amen. Amen. Ladies, we just want to say we're so proud of y'all. God has you in a place where you need to be, where you need to be loved, where you see hope in action, where you see faith in action, and you see miracles in action, because you are a miracle. Amen. And you are a testimony to the body of Christ. And so we're just so proud of you and proud of where you're headed. Amen. If y'all would, just stand with me. Ladies, could y'all do me a favor and just come right here? We want to pray a blessing. By the way, they have some things in the foyer for sale if y'all want to take advantage of that, if you want to get to know them, if you want to get to meet them and just congratulate them. I think it would be good for us to send them off back to Franklin, right? Amen? I'm talking Baldwin, Sherrington, Irish Bend Road, come on, Centerville. And so we just want to send you guys off and just let you know. And I wanted these people to see your faces, because these are the faces of God's testimony. These are the faces of ladies who are overcomers and are facing and have faced adversity. But they're going to walk through this, amen, and not feel defeated because of what society has labeled them. But God has never abandoned them. A wonderful story. My favorite story, although I have a lot of favorite stories in the Bible, but one of my favorite stories is the lady who was about to be stoned to death. She was caught in adultery. I think it's John chapter 8 or 9. I can't remember. But Jesus comes to kind of her rescue, writes something in the sand. We don't know what he wrote. And Jesus gets up and says, hey, if anybody is here without sin, let him throw the first stone. Well, they got convicted and they dropped their stones and they walked away. And then scripture says Jesus was left there standing with her. And that is a powerful testimony that Jesus never turns his back on his children. Amen. He didn't leave that lady by herself. And these ladies are a powerful testimony to who God is. Because you're seeing miracles right before. A lot of them, a miracle just to come up here and stand in front of people and speak and sing. But God is a God of miracles. And so we wanted to bring them, the men from the Bro Bridge, that's what I was thinking, came last year and did a very similar program. And so we're excited for y'all where God is taking you. And let me just say this, ladies, life is not meant to be a private matter. You need to testify to God's goodness every place you go, to your family. They need to see and hear and see the wonderful power of God doing miracles right before their eyes. You know, sometimes we think healing is the only miracle. No. Release from the power of addiction is, I believe, one of the greatest miracles. Amen. And look, I believe this with all my heart. There were probably people in Jesus' day that had addictions as well. But we cannot lose hope. And so it's encouragement to you, the congregation, and those that are watching online, that if you are struggling, God wants to meet you exactly where you are. And He has you on a faith journey. And He has you exactly where you need to be. And where are you going to go? And so, ladies, we just wanted to say, hey, we're so proud of you. Pastor Brandon and Miss Cassie are actually out. They're our lead pastor. They're on a sabbatical for about a month. But their well wishes are to you and to your testimonies and to what God has for you. Amen. And so stretch out your hand, congregation, to them. Father, we just stretch out our hands to these ladies. They are a testimony to who you are. In the name of Christ. And so, Lord, we pray a blessing over them. We pray, Lord, for their future journey with you. We don't know where that's going to be, but Lord, you do. And so, Lord, I pray And we pray as a congregation that by faith, these ladies will not just survive, but they shall thrive. These ladies shall move forward with their lives and show the goodness of God. Lord, like the lady who was at the well, she ran back and says, "You would not believe who I just spoke to." And she was a testament to what God did in her life. And so, Father, we pray a blessing over them. Lord, we send them back to Franklin area. We send them back, Lord, with encouragement. We send them back with hope. Most importantly, we send them back with our prayers that you will nurture them, you will birth them, you will cultivate them. Lord, a life of Jesus in them. Lord, use these ladies as a testimony to the goodness of God and the healing power of God. Lord, I pray a blessing over every one of these ladies and also the leaders. We pray the favor of God, the blessing of God, the anointing of God. May there be an anointing unleashed like they've never seen before. Lord, I pray that as they go out, as they conquer, Lord, that they shall be overcomers. And Lord, you have called them, Lord, to a power. You have called them, Lord, to a destiny, to a purpose. And Lord, that purpose, Lord, is a wonderful journey with you. Lord, we pray that, Lord, you walk with them, you encourage, you teach, you show, and most importantly, Lord, you continue with them on their path. And Lord, as a church here in Lafayette, we undergird them. We pray a mighty blessing of the name of Jesus over them tonight. In the wonderful name of Jesus, we pray. And everybody said, amen and amen and amen. Amen. Well, ladies, thank y'all for coming. If you need to man your booth, go ahead. But look, hey, stay a while. Get to know them. Get to know who they are. Buy a couple gifts so that you can help support this ministry because it is an important ministry. Amen. Ladies, thank y'all for coming. We love y'all and we support y'all. In Jesus' name, amen.